Padmi got the inside of the reach of Colbey. Says she's got the power to knock Colbey out tonight. Colbey throws with the jab, the high kick early. Packs her up. Putri Padmi is game. Chance to right hand. There's another one from Colbey Northcutt. Here comes Northcutt. It has some fire. And Putri Padmi gets inside the phone booth and ties her up. Looking for a takedown, Putri Padmi.
Northcutt to start to get extended. She's got to try to stack her. She's got to try to stack her and then pull that arm out. Get that arm away from the joint manipulation right there that she's doing. Now you can see Colby's transferring to a triangle. She's trying to. Tommy's doing a good job of kind of shutting that down and keeping her arms nice and tight to the body. Northcutt is going back to the arm bar though.
And she survived another attempt at the arm bar. Gets an intestinal fortitude, but is it enough? Is it enough? She looks down. Okay.
Flexible arms right there, so Northcutt might have to choke her if she wants to finish this on the ground. Now she's getting deep into the triangle. This is what she wanted. Those long legs give her a very good advantage in snatching up some triangles. And now she's got to try to adjust right now. Now she's got to try to turn her body and put her head kind of to the other side. That's it. She's got to adjust.
Putri Padmi, tremendous strength, tremendous resilience. But how long can she survive with Colbey Northcutt throwing up submission after submission? Putri Padmi would like to break this open and bring down the crowd and power. There's some halfish jumps for the Indonesian.
Padmi is incredibly tough. She's doing a good job of defending. See how high her shoulder is to her chin? That's going to give her a little bit of space to breathe. Now, if Northcutt chooses to go under the leg, I think she is. I think she's under the leg. Now she might be able to create a little bit more torque onto that choke. Padmi's got to keep her stacked. She can't allow her to extend. Can't allow this choke to get tighter and tighter. There might be some elbows possibly right here for Padmi.
What a debut so far from Colbey Northcutt, the 36-time karate world champion. A nice thing to the side of the head there from Putri Padmi.
That's what Padmi needs to start doing. She's got to utilize this opportunity to deliver some ground and pound. She can't allow these minor little adjustments from Northcutt. She's got to start ground and pound, deliver some knees, deliver some hands. Create some separation here, but this is a little bit awkward position. You can see just how tight the triangle choke is, but I think Padmi might have enough room to breathe.
There's some little peppering punches off the right hand there from Putri Padmi, trying to get Colbey Northcutt to break this hold. As Colbey hands out the submission, foul down bars. Now the triangle trying to make her tap out, but Putri Padmi's not going to go quite into the night. Still surviving here, the Indonesian, with 80 seconds remaining.
Work to finish. She looks relaxed. She's not really trying to gas herself out at this point. She knows just how tough Padmi is. This is the third submission attempt that Padmi's been able to survive, and she looks to be okay.
Putri Padmi, 11-1 in karate, 5-0 Muay Thai, 5-0 amateur boxing. Still stuck in the triangle.
It's starting to get a little bit tight now. She's going back to the armbar.
Have a look at this. Is this the end now? Is this the finish? No, Putri Padmi survived.
Wow, how tough is Putri Padmi? Sweep there by Colbey Northcutt. End up on top, and she's going after the choke. She's got an arm in guillotine, but the arm's on the wrong side. Padmi might be able to defend here.
One transition to submission to another from Colbey Northcutt in a thrilling debut so far. No transiting karate ground belt, Putri Padmi to use the karate at the moment. Meanwhile, Colbey Northcutt, 4-1 amateur mixed martial arts, 1-0 pro kickboxing, jiu-jitsu purple belt, showing some of the jiu-jitsu on the ground here.
Looks like we're going to see a second round. You got to wonder how all these submission attempts are going to affect Northcutt into the second round, because Padmi's been able to survive a lot of dangerous positions.
Also, psychologically, how does it affect Colbey? A lot of people thought she would get Putri Padmi out.
There are a lot of good submission attempts on that first round. I think Colbey Northcutt needs to change things up. I think she needs to do the work on the feet, deliver some of that powerful striking that she's known for. Because on the ground, I don't think she can finish Padmi.
Good figure, Padmi is open for a rear leg roundhouse kick. Off the ground, making Colbey Northcutt. Can she throw it? But what's she getting?
I mean, he's keep those hands nice and tight to her face. You can see sniper. Colbey Northcutt trying to pick her shot.
Here of Northcutt might not be wide. Is she guessed a little here, the Indonesian? Throws a right hand, dances up to the left. An overwhelming 81% of fans on Rocket Fantasy, the world's largest martial arts fantasy game, tipping a win on debut from Colbey Northcutt tonight. And again, the evasion here from Putri Padmi.
Northcutt, she's able to kind of set things up with the jab, but then boom, with the straight right hand. And there's another one of those big head kicks.
That's the Mawashi Getty I spoke about, the rear legs right roundhouse kick from Colbey Northcutt. Put to the damage here on Padmi. It's just the size, the reach of Colbey Northcutt, the extension in those arms. But look at Padmi, covers up against the high right ground kick, and still she rallies back to Indonesia. What heart! Can she go into the well? Can she dig down deep? Flurry forward and back up, Colbey Northcutt. Right hand counter. Is Colbey Northcutt's confidence still riding as high as it was, say, 7 minutes ago, Mitch?
I think her confidence is even higher because she knows just how much control she has in this match. Everything she's throwing is landing. Her submissions are just micro inches away from finishing Padmi, but she just needs to find that one big shot, find that one big submission, because right now she's piecing Padmi up. But she also knows that Padmi is tough as nails, and there is no quitting this young lady.
Yoko getting signed kick pinned from Northcutt. Putri Padmi quickly in with a left hook followed by a right uppercut. Trying to get on the inside, into that proverbial phone booth with the towering Colbey Northcutt. There's a good gut muncher from Putri Padmi.
She needs to keep that head moving. She can't allow her head to stay in the same spot, especially when Northcutt throws the second shot. That second shot is right down the middle, and it's got a lot of heat behind it. The only thing that might be worried about with Northcutt is her gassing out, her throwing everything she has into at Padmi, and Padmi being able to take it and just wear this in the third round.
Not looking as confident on the feet as she was in the ground game is Colbey Northcutt. Trying to sit behind the extension, behind the incredible reach of the American. Only 50 remains, second round of three. First round was all one-way traffic, and that traffic was driving to Texas to Colbey Northcutt.
Padmi is an Indonesian Muay Thai champion. She is undefeated in Muay Thai, undefeated in amateur boxing. So she knows what she needs to be doing out there to capture the win. And I think at this point, she's just kind of riding the wave. She's surviving a lot of the early onslaught. And she's going to try to push this thing into deep water.
Needs to get a little bit more mustard behind these elbows. There's Colbey Northcutt. She's throwing the kick, she's throwing the hands. They landed, but they haven't affected Padmi with the power. And Padmi get on the inside. It's been a glorified kickboxing contest here in the second round.
She's trying to set up that big right hand. You see the way she's stepping her kicks. She's trying to set up that big right hand, but Northcutt's very elusive. Sliding out of the way of these things. Not there for the retaliation of Padmi.
Colbey Northcutt on a one championship debut. Double jab right hand. She thought about it, did Padmi. Didn't have the distance in. Trying to edge away on the inside. Each the jab drops. The two punch combination from the American. Colbey comes forward again. Throws the hook in there for good measure.
I see Padmi start throwing some big kicks. This is how agile Northcutt is. Always on the balls of the feet, always moving. The only thing Padmi's doing is throwing those hands. I guess she's going to the body right there, but she needs to start doing some damage to the legs as well.
Colbey controlling the stand-up, although the elbows have not been powerful. There's a bit of washigiri from Colbey Northcutt. Good jab from Putri Padmi. Overhand right from the Indonesian. End of the round, we've got to be jealous after two. A lot of people thought we wouldn't see Putri Padmi in the third round, but she's still here. She's still game. Into jab from her. Colbey Northcutt. Jab two, kangaroo from Northcutt. Another jab. Padmi trying to get on the inside. Into the round kick. Tries to bridge the gap. Forearms high. Higeri, washigeri from Colbey Northcutt. Skip inside, fly kick from Padmi. Northcutt's chin up high in the air. She believes the height will prevent people from reaching her back. Tell you what, and again, maybe Padmi can get airborne with a left hook and an uppercut. Chest that chin up, Colbey Northcutt. Colbey smiles at him. As Mitch said, there was an injury to the right leg of Colbey Northcutt. They were icing it down between rounds. That's the back leg of the American. Maybe a target for Putri Padmi to go after. Certainly got to get on the inside. Get inside the range here of Northcutt. Jab down from Padmi, overhand right. That's very likely. Go for the headache maker. Happy to hear a curve on Northcutt. Kicking the elbow of Padmi in the second round. Throws that kick. Sticks it up for this time. Moves it hovering. Goes to a side kick. Pushes in the lead block. Padmi playing one game.
Padmi says, I can balance on one leg too. What you got?
I like the showmanship here from the Indonesian.
You see a little bit more aggression coming out of Northcutt. Right now she's okay to just stand at the end, keep Padmi at the back foot, and just kind of touch her up a little bit. That's a little bit more aggression coming from Padmi. That's what Padmi needs to do. She needs to make this dirty. She needs to get in close. Avoid the range game of Northcutt and start landing those big right hands.
Maybe Northcutt really playing a point scoring karate game at the moment. These blows aren't going to knock down Putri Padmi. This isn't karate point scoring. That's more like it. A little bit more gusto behind that round kick from Colbey Northcutt.
Man, the chin on Padmi. She's just taking these shots, coming forward, pawing out there with her left hand, trying to set up the big right hand. But just the distance and range of Northcutt is just something truly spectacular. I mean, she's been in here hundreds of times, ladies and gentlemen. A 36 times martial arts world champion. So you know just how good she is on the feet and how she understands her own distance.
Hundreds of times mixed under those karate point-scoring rules, but only a handful of times in mixed martial arts. And the more that Northcutt will go through the ranks here from the championship, she's going to have to start to really load up power on these strikes.
She's also a Texas State Golden Gloves boxing champion, so she knows how to put power into those hands, but she's playing it kind of safe at this point. She's doing just enough to keep Padmi right where she is and touch her up, and that's what this is pretty much boiling down to. Not seeing a lot of big risks taken by Northcutt. We're not seeing any sort of big fancy knockout kicks that she's trying to throw.
It's a matter of reach being the difference here. 11 centimeters taller, as I said, the wingspan of an albatross on Colbey Northcutt. And Padmi's had trouble all night getting on the inside. A couple of times she's gotten there, a couple of times she's put the leather on the face of Colbey Northcutt, like with that jab. There she goes for the uppercut. She needs to come in and go for a full-on flurry. Put the pedal down. Throw caution to the wind. Pull out all the stops here. Putri Padmi to have a chance to turn the tide. Because at the moment, the reach, and there's another solid 1-2 from Northcutt, is just dominating Padmi.
I think this is going to do a lot of good, sort of work for Putri Padmi's stop. I think, getting out there, doing work with a, 36-time martial arts world champion is only going to boost her own learning in this game. And that's kind of what's happening right here. She's going to learn from these mistakes, but also, Northcutt is going to go back in and say, I want to be a finisher. I just don't want to go out there and outpoint people. I want to end people's night, and I need to make these necessary adjustments to make that happen.
Sitting behind the jab and the lead hook, Colbey Northcutt, 30 seconds to go now. Sticks off, getting the block right. Block right, I should say. Another jab there from Northcutt. Good defense against the man, getting front kick. Jab from Padmi. A has she got a couple of big salvos left for the artillery, the Indonesian. Jab, flicking jab to the jaw there from Northcutt. Big defense. Padmi tries to get him inside now with a flurry. Quarter angle turn, little pirouette though from the Texan. Overhand right from Padmi. Final seconds. We go to the judges. It'll comfortably go the way of Colbey Northcutt.
All three judges have called this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, Colbey Northcutt.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.